Hey there, everyone. My name is Sammy Maddox, and I am an ambassador for the El Paso Society of Musicians of the Future. In a previous video, we covered all the instruments found in a symphony orchestra. Today, I would like to turn our attention to an instrument not necessarily found in an orchestra. This instrument is not made out of wood, plastic, brass, or even ivory, which is quite old. But in fact, this instrument is found in our own bodies. No, this instrument is not our internal organs. This instrument is the voice. An ensemble of voices or a choir can produce magnificent harmonies and melodies just by singing. Like the symphony, the choir is made up in four parts: soprano, alto, tenor, and bass. So, without further ado, let's unpack each of the four parts of the choir. Now, up first, we have the soprano voice. The soprano voice is usually sung by females because it is the highest of the four voices, ranging from C4 all the way up to C6. In fact, sopra is Italian for above. Since it is relatively easy for higher pitches to project sound, sopranos are used to singing the melody. In addition, the soprano voice is extremely bright in tone. All other voices will look to the soprano voice as the guide of the music. Now, some good examples of the soprano voice are Whitney Houston and Mariah Carey. Furthermore, Philippa Sue, an actress who plays Elizabeth Schuyler in the musical Hamilton, is a soprano. Now, next up is the alto voice. The alto voice is sung by females with a low voice or males with a high voice. It is the second highest voice in a choir and ranges from around F3 to F5. Now, in Latin, alto means high, although not as high as the soprano. Altos work closely with the sopranos, and the alto voice is what provides the main harmonies to the melodies in a piece. Other times, the alto can double the soprano melody to create a very full and rich feeling. The tone of the alto voice is very warm, full, and rich. It is the range where most people are comfortable singing. Now, a couple good examples today of alto singers are Adele and Gladys Knight. Now, let's look at the tenor voice. The tenor voice is typically sung by males. It is the second lowest vocal voice, ranging from around C3 to C5, which is actually my vocal range. Between the years of 1250 and 1500, the tenor voice was considered as the structurally fundamental voice in polyphony because it carried out the holding voice. Now, the Latin word for holding is tenere, so you can see where the tenor voice came from. Now, the tenor voice usually harmonizes above the lead, who sings the melody. Now, some excellent examples of tenors are Jon Bon Jovi, Adam Lambert, Elton John, and one of my favorites, Michael Jackson. Now, last but definitely not least, we have the bass voice. The bass voice is the lowest voice in a choir, as the Latin name bassus, meaning short and slow, suggests, and it is sung by males. The bass part is also very fundamental to music theory. The placement of the bass note in a chord, in large part, determines the direction of the music. Basses do for low notes what sopranos do for high notes, and they have a vocal range of around E2 to E4, which is considerably low. The volume and strength with which bass singers can sing lower notes is quite remarkable, considering that pitches lower on the musical scale are very hard for many people to pick up, especially when there is an orchestra or choir playing at the same time. Now, some very excellent bass singers include Johnny Cash, Evie Kaplan, and Barry White. Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen, the four voices of the choir. I encourage all of you to go and do some experimenting at home and find out which voice best represents your voice. And do this with your family and friends, and maybe you could even start your own choir. Now, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with others. As always, never stop learning. Adios, amigos.